Why people become lazy and what are its remedies? How we can overcome this habit? Procrastination is a contagious disease which spoils the foundation or base of any nation and society. Procrastination is to leave the things, work and responsibility pending on the hope that tomorrow or at any other day I will do this, I will perform this work. It means a person leaves the responsibilities what he or she can perform today. This is called procrastination or laziness. A person becomes habitual of this habit gradually. His tasks are not completed. He forgets his responsibilities. Disturbance, laziness, anxiety, and many other psychological, internal, and physical diseases overcome him. Thus, his life ends in a very painful manner. We can better understand it through an example. Today you are healthy and powerful. You are not ready to complete your tasks. God forbid, if you are sick, how would you fulfill your duties tomorrow? You can understand with the help of another example. Suppose you have been assigned a duty to cut a tree. With the very habit of procrastination, you delay till a year. What will happen? With the every passing day, the roots of the tree would become stronger and stronger, and you perhaps will not be so healthy and powerful. When you could not root it out in spite of good health, how you can do so today with weak body? So, due to our behavior and temperament to delay some most important tasks for unimportant things is called procrastination. What are its reasons? Number one, sometimes we leave our task due to the fact that we haven't any mood. Number two, we wait for the right time and peace of mind. Number three, we waste our time as we think that there is enough age and enough time for this task. The Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, every day at the time of dawn, a new day awaits us and says, O Adam's son, I am the new creation of Allah and witness of your deeds and actions, so that avail and take what you can gather today. I will never come back again. One other reason of procrastination is that most of the people like to remain in the past, remembering good and bad things of the past and thinking plans for the future. Another hadith tells us about a true Muslim. A true Muslim has two types of fear. One is for the past, which he does not know what result Allah will show for his deeds and actions. And other is the future, whose knowledge nobody has what will happen in future. So the advice is that man, for the sake of his own self, be thankful to Allah for his health before sickness, for youth before old age, and life before death. Tomorrow our deceit. Yes, our life's tomorrow is a great deceit, which saves the man from the shame and sadness of wasting time. About tomorrow, it is said that no word is most answerable of fake hopes, promises breaking, full of follies and laziness, than the word of tomorrow, because this tomorrow will never come again. Its disadvantages are both internal and external. Yes, this procrastination has disadvantages. So come towards its remedies. Some remedies are the following. How can we overcome our habit of laziness? Number one, planning and reflection, morning to evening. Number one, our plans for our tasks with time will never let you sit idle. Number two, to awake early will provide you the chance to start early and finish your work properly. Number three, search for the reasons why you become so lazy. What are its reasons behind it? Its possible reasons can be when our aims, number one, thing is that when our aim in life are not clear. Number two, priorities of our tasks are not fixed. Number three, lack of consciousness about the important tasks. Division of tasks is not very clear. What is important and what is unimportant? Perhaps we become lazy due to some reasons, maybe fear of failure, wrong self-analysis, keep thinking and thinking about our mistakes. So what should we do? You must take action. Planning and action. Number one, clear objectives of life will save your time. Number two, knowledge of reality. Number three, give yourself deadline about anything or any task. Number four, make plan and target daily. Number five, pray from Allah for your success. Number six, adopt the formula now or never, as we got Pakistan. I hope these remedies will help you to overcome your procrastination. Please like and share if you like it. Thank you for watching.